This is the Anonymous News Network. Greetings, members of NATO. We are Anonymous. In a recent publication, you have singled out Anonymous as a threat to government and the people. You have also alleged that secrecy is a necessary evil, and that transparency is not always the right way forward. Anonymous would like to remind you that the government and the people are distinct entities with often conflicting goals and desires. It is Anonymous's position that when there is a conflict of interest between the government and the people, it is the people's will which must take priority. The only threat transparency poses to government is to threaten government's ability to act in a manner which the people would disagree. Anonymous does not accept that the government or the military has the right to be above the law and to use national security to justify illegal and deceptive activities. Dishonesty and secrecy totally undermine the concept of self-rule. How can the people judge for whom to vote, unless they are fully aware of what policies said politicians are actually pursuing? When a government is elected, it is said to represent the nation it governs. This essentially means that the actions of a government are not the actions of the people in government, but are actions taken on behalf of every citizen in that country. Anonymous and WikiLeaks do share one common attribute: they are no threat to any organization, unless that organization is doing something wrong and attempting to get away with it. We do not wish to threaten a way of life. We do not wish to dictate anything to anyone. We do not wish to terrorize any nation. We merely wish to remove power from vested interests and return it to the people, who, in a democracy, it should never have been removed from, in the first place. The government enforces the law. This does not give them the right to break it. If the government was doing nothing illegal, there would be nothing embarrassing about WikiLeaks revelations, nor would there have been any scandal emanating from HB Gary. The resulting scandals were not a result of Anonymous or WikiLeaks revelations, they were the result of the content released. The responsibility for that content can be placed solely at the doorstep of policymakers who, like any corrupt entity, naively believed that they were above the law and that they would not be exposed. A lot of government and corporate comment has been dedicated to how we can avoid a similar leak in the future. Such advice ranges from better security, to lower levels of clearance, from harsher penalties for whistleblowers, to censorship of the press. Our message is simple: do not lie to the people. Do not make corrupt deals and you won't have to worry about your corruption being laid bare. Do not break the rules in which you enforce upon the people. You know you do not fear us because we are a threat to society. You fear us because we are a threat to the established hierarchy. Anonymous has proven over the last several years that a hierarchy is not necessary in order to achieve great things. Perhaps what you truly fear in us is the realization of your own irrelevance in an age which has outgrown its reliance on you. Your true terror is not in a collective of activists, but in the fact that you and everything you stand for, by the changing tides and the advancement of technology, have become outdated. Finally, do not make the mistake of challenging Anonymous. Do not make the mistake of believing you can stop us. If you cut down one Anon, 10 more will join us, purely out of anger at your trampling of human rights. Your only chance of defeating the movement which binds all of us is to accept it. This is no longer your world. It is our world, the people's world. We are Anonymous. We are Legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.